So we just learned about partial derivatives of a function of several variables. You know that one of the main applications of derivatives in a function of a single variable is to find maximum and minimum of functions. It also works for functions of several variables. And I want to illustrate that by example. And the example I'll give is rather a classic example. It's called the method of least squares. If you took my Matrix Algebra for Engineers course, you would have seen this example already using matrices and vector spaces. Here, I'll show you how to solve this problem using partial derivatives. So the problem is that you have a bunch of data shown as these dots. So the data we can write as xi, yi. And the xi are supposed to be given, and the yi are supposed to be noisy. And here I equals 1 to n. So we have n data points, okay? So the key here is that the x's are supposed to be known for the data, right? That's the independent variable. And the y's are the measurements. Those are the dependent variables. And from an experiment, they typically come out with some noise in them. But maybe that the theory is such that this data should fit a straight line, and then you want to draw the best straight line that goes through the data points, typically because you're interested in the slope of the line. So you want to try and compute the slope of the line. So we want to then try to fit a line to the data. So the data is here. The fit then is this line, which I'll call y equals beta naught plus beta 1 times x. Okay? So my claim then is this the y data are related through to the x data. The dependent variable is related to the independent variable by a linear relationship. That's the line. Okay. So how do we find the optimum values of beta naught and beta 1? These are the unknowns here. These two fitting parameters. So we construct a function. So the function I'm going to call f is a function of beta naught and beta 1, the parameters that we want to determine. This is equal to a sum over all the data, so we sum over I, of the function beta naught plus beta 1 xi, right? So the function evaluated at I, that's supposed to be yi. So that's the xi minus yi. So beta naught plus beta 1 xi is the fit y at the value of xi. So that's the line. And the yi then are the purple dots. And the difference between these two, right? So the difference is this length here is the difference between those two. We want the square of all of those lengths to be minimized, okay? So we want to minimize the square of the sum of all of these lengths, the distance between the data and the line. That's why it's called the method of least squares. Okay. So this is our function, a function of our two parameters, beta naught and beta 1. And we want to minimize the value of f. So just like in a single variable calculus, we can set the partial derivatives of f with respect to each of these two variables equal to 0 to find the minimum. Okay, we know there is a minimum because there's no maximum, because we can make this line as far away from these data points as we can. So we know that there's a minimum, and we can find the minimum by solving the partial of f with respect to beta naught equals 0, and the partial of f with respect to beta 1 equals 0. In just the same way we do in single variable calculus. Okay, so let's take the derivative. So the derivative of this with respect to beta naught gives us, we bring down the 2 and set it equal to 0. So we end up with the sum over I 2 beta naught plus beta 1 xi minus yi equals 0. Then the partial of f with respect to beta 1, we have to apply the chain rule here. So it's the derivative of the outside times the derivative of the inside. The inside then will bring out an xi. So we have the sum over I. So we have 2 times beta naught plus beta 1 xi minus yi times the derivative of the inside with respect to beta 1, which will be times xi, and that's supposed to be equal to 0. Okay. These are supposed to be two equations for the two unknowns, beta naught and beta 1. Can we write it in a nicer way so we can see the two equations? So first of all, that 2 is not important, right? We can divide by 2. So let me get rid of the 2. And then we want to write a something times beta naught plus a constant times beta naught plus a constant times beta 1 equals a constant. So the first equation, we have a sum over I of beta naught. So that means we have beta naught plus beta naught plus beta naught n times. I goes from 1 to n, right? So we're summing beta naught n times. So that first equation, we have an n times beta naught. And then we have a sum over I of xi times beta 1. So we have a plus sum over I xi times beta 1. And then the right-hand side is going to be the sum over I times yi. So the right-hand side is the sum over I times yi. So that's called the inhomogeneous term. So we have the number of data points n times beta naught plus the sum over all of the x variables times beta 1 is equal to the sum over all the y variables. That's the first equation. The second equation, we have a sum over I beta naught xi. So we have a sum over xi times beta naught from this first term. And then the beta 1 term, we have a sum over I xi times xi, or xi squared. So we have a plus a sum over I xi squared times beta 1. And that's equal to the inhomogeneous term. The inhomogeneous term will be, there's a minus yi xi, or xi yi. We bring that to the right-hand side. So we have a sum over I xi yi. Okay? Two equations and two unknowns. Our unknowns are beta naught and beta 1, the fitting parameters. The coefficients depend on the data. There's n data. We can add all of the x's. We can add all of the x's squared. We can add all of the y's. And we can multiply all of the x's and the y's and then add them. So these are all constants depending on the data. Beta naught, beta 1 are the unknowns. I can solve this equation. I've done it multiple times. But there's not enough light board to show you. The way I would solve this equation is to write this as a matrix equation and then invert the matrix and then multiply. But you can try it at home if you desire. But I can write down the answer. So the answer I have written over here, because I won't remember it, is beta naught equals the sum over xi squared, sum over yi, minus the sum over xi yi times the sum over xi divided by the denominator, which is n times the sum over xi squared minus the sum over xi, that whole thing squared. And then beta 1 is another complicated expression, n times the sum over xi yi minus the sum over xi times the sum over yi divided by the same denominator, which is n sum over xi squared minus sum over xi squared. Okay, you don't memorize this type of formula. And in fact, if you have a big data set and you wanted to compute this, you would not compute it this way. You would compute it using matrices in the method that I taught you in matrix algebra for engineers. But the two results are exactly the same. And for a very small dimensional data set, you can do it by hand and try it out. I'd give that to you as a problem, and it will actually be the same problem that you might have done in the matrix algebra course. So you can see it's the same answer. Okay, let me review. This is an application of using partial derivatives to find the minimum of a function. Here, we're minimizing the sum of the squares by determining the parameters beta naught and beta 1. So we set the partial derivatives of this function with respect to beta naught and with respect to beta 1 equals 0. That gives us a system of two equations and two unknowns, which you can solve by any method that you like. Okay, I hope this gives you a taste of using partial derivatives to minimize functions. There's a lot of additional details that I skip in this course because typically they're not particularly useful. But in a math course, sometimes the math professor likes to talk about it. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.